new tonight, a behind-the-scenes look at what's shaping up to be a record summer travel season. Just how many people are flying? TSA tells us they expect the number of passengers going through MSP to rise above 40,000 on 31 days this summer. That compares to just 6 days with that many passengers last summer. That's a whole lot of people to keep safe. So how do they do it? KARE 11's Zachary Lajoie gives us a rare look at the security you don't see at our airport during what's expected to be an unprecedented summer travel season.
Many of us are familiar with TSA checkpoints at airports. In fact, it's probably the most, if not only thing, we know about security at airports. But there's a lot we don't know or see.
There's layers even before you get to the airport.
Like the moment you book your reservation.
When you give your full name, your gender, your date of birth, that information is used to run through a system called Secure Flight, where traveling population is vetted against a terrorist watch list.
Yes.
Lori Dankers, a spokeswoman with TSA, says that list is maintained by the FBI.
So if somebody is on a terrorist watch list, they can purchase a ticket. However, they will not be allowed to print a boarding pass.
So what if you have a common name and end up on the list? The Department of Homeland Security has a way to help clear your name.
There's a unique number assigned to you, so when you book your ticket next time, you'll include that information so they know who you are to allow you to fly in the system.
It's travel day, and you're at the airport.
Just gonna sniff you here, guys.
Chances are you'll see a bomb-sniffing dog screening travelers for explosives. But what you won't see is the work being done in MSP's explosives lab, where passengers aren't allowed.
Explosives are still the biggest threat to aviation security.
In the lab, not only do specialists inspect suspicious items.
So this is cologne shaped in a grenade bottle. That's how they manufactured, that's how it comes. Obviously, this is something you don't want to bring to the airport.
They also recreate life threats as examples for training.
Everybody's heard of the Richard Reed, the shoe bomb. So again, here's your shoe bomb. We've modified these shoes.
Last year alone, 2,000 items were flagged, including
firearms in their carry-on bags. And passengers often say that they forgot or didn't know that the gun was in their bag. Everything stops in that lane, and the airport police here respond very, very quickly, and it becomes a law enforcement matter with that passenger.
While you're getting screened, so is your baggage. Ever wonder where it goes? Once the airline employee puts your baggage on the conveyor belt, the inline baggage system routes it through an explosive detection system, which quickly captures an image to determine if the bag contains any type of threat. In Terminal 1, that 6-mile journey can take 12 to 15 minutes to get from the ticket counter to the plane, if it's not flagged. If your bag is flagged for further screening, it's checked here inside the checked baggage resolution area. Now, if your bag is opened by a TSA officer, you'll receive one of these notices. Nationwide, less than 5% of checked bags need a physical inspection. Those inspections are recorded on camera. You and your baggage aren't the only things being screened. All employees who work beyond airport checkpoints are screened as well.
Even though they have access to the airport, we still check their ID verification, and we screen their property before they come in.
With summer travel sizzling to an all-new high, TSA says it's their job to make sure everyone feels safe and confident when traveling.
I like to always say that security is seen and unseen, and it's the unseen parts that really are working to ensure that the system is safe.
In Minneapolis, Zachary Lajoie, KARE 11 News.